What's up? What's good, y'all? All right. I'm going to show y'all something here. Now, before y'all laugh, because I know y'all going to be laughing, this is serious. This is a tool. Like, if you have a condition like me, this will help. Okay? All right. First, I'm going to show y'all some updates with the trailer real quick. Then I'm going to show y'all this tool. And I'm serious. Okay? All right. So, let me swing the camera around. And then I'm going to show y'all the quick updates. Then we're going to get into it. All right? All right. Alright peeps, let me show y'all these real quick before they get all dirty. Alright, see, I got some new fresh bodies because I tore them other bodies up. And the old lady stickered them up. She did a great job on these things. She did a hell of a job on them. I messed that up a little bit, but that's okay. But I needed some new practice bodies, you know, or bodies, period. You know what I'm saying? So she stick a kid in them up nicely. She did them up really good. She did the bodies out really nice, so it came out good. All right, I just wanted to get y'all that before they get dirty. I see the popping banner. Shout out to Brent from Bones Motorsports. Hooked me up with that banner. Nice, it's popping. Thank you, Brent, appreciate it, good brother. All right, y'all know all this stuff is still the same, air compressor. Cabinet, all that's still the same. Put some parts here. Do my thing. Not really nothing major changes. Nothing. Gluing up some tires. Put a cabinet there. Nothing really changed. All right. One, if you got this TV here, this is the Philips Roku edition or whatever. Roku TV. All right. Don't get this TV, but let's say you did. Right, because it's not expensive, but let's say you did, don't come with a browser. And you know, when you're at the races, it's normally everybody checks Live RC to find out where they at position wise, qualifiers, what's going on in real time. All right, but this doesn't have a browser, so the way around that is get you a Fire Stick. Shout out to my man JB because he put me, he actually one who said, yo, what about using a Fire Stick? And I was like, damn, I didn't think about that. Fire Stick works good. As you can see, browsing all day. I'm on Live RC now. And, you know, you just find your track. So you just go Live RC. And normally you just go to your search here. Boom. And type in your track that you at or racing. If they got Live RC, most of them do. And boom, it'll come up. And everything will be in real time. So, okay. So that's live5rc.com. All right, so that's the way to get a browser on this TV, this Philips Roku edition or whatever. Okay, put some parts there, whatever. Let me show y'all something here. I'm getting ready to show y'all some motors done. My 301 done, 302 done. Thing is, man, I got gallons on these joints. It's time to rebuild them. It just sucks, man. But, you know, I'm about to rebuild them. They just need repension. Probably some front bearings. Let me see. Here we go. So, this is the piston and sleeve kit for this. If anybody has it out here, this Keep Off 4. Let me see if I can take this out the bag for you here real quick. Damn, it's hard doing this with one hand. Hold on, y'all. All right, this is the Keep All 4. No Rossi. This is the piston, sleeve, and rod. All right, it's part number for you right there. Wait, hold on 1 second. All right, part number for you right there. Okay, if you need it. All right, now, what's happening is, man, I've got gallons on these motors. Like, these ones I was running when I was running Byron. So, you know, these things got gallons. So, what's happening is I got to put practice motors in and stop practicing and racing with the same motor. Because I'm putting too many gallons on these things. So, but let me show you when it's time for a rebuild. Hold on, people. Okay. So you already know how to do the piston. You know, you put your piston in there, exhaust side, whatever the case may be, right? Boom, push it up. See that? That's a tippy top. It's a wrap. Push that in there. See that? It's a wrap. So, I was having issues with these joints, and that was the issue. You know, it's time for rebuild. So, normally when I rebuild them, I could send these out to get repinched. And what I'll probably do is just send, because you could just send your piston and your sleeve out to get repinched. So, I might just send that out to get repinched, but put a new piston and sleeve in there. And, you know, good to go. So, yeah, it is time for these things. And it's all good. But what I've been running is my old good, the K3 in there. It's been running excellent. K5 still, 501 still hanging in there. I'm going to rebuild this. And I still got my brand new K302. So, it's just time for these things to get rebuilt. So, that's it. Okay. Now, what did I do? Oh, all right. So let's go outside. I'm gonna show y'all this real quick. It's popping. Some gangster for y'all. All right. I'm gonna leave a link for this. So I got the keyless pad entry joint here. So it come with a little fob doohickey. So if I wanna unlock it, here we go. See that? I'll show y'all the lock. Oops, sorry. So if I lock it. Push the key fob. Good to go. See that? Just like that. Now you can put your code in. I ain't gonna show y'all my code, but you know, or you can hold this lock key down. Good to go. Gangster. I'll leave a link for that in the description. Alright, that's gangster. Alright. Alright, so you got a condition like me, this tool will come in handy for you, okay? Before you laugh, think about this. Now, you got a camper, you're good. You got an enclosed trailer, or say you tenting at the track, or camping, whatever, right? You don't like using porta potties or public bathrooms like me, okay? Here you go. Solution, this is a portable toilet, right? Now, before you laugh, this thing works great. Look at that. It's clean, by the way. So don't even worry about it. Alright. I'm going to leave a link for this thing. Now, look at here. Very simple to use. And it works great. Okay. So, let me show you how it breaks down. Right here. You fill up this thing with water. It takes like 3 gallons up top. Down bottom. That's where your waste, whatever goes. It's like 5 gallons at the bottom. All right, it'll waste, it'll hold. That's the meter on there, show you. That shows you how much, if it's getting full, okay, it starts turning red. That's when you need to dump it, okay? So, once you fill up with water, so say, you know, you're about to handle your business or whatever, right? First, I'm gonna tell you something, before you handle your business, pull this out, that's how it flush, but get, cause it'll build up pressure, like I keep it in the back of my truck. Builds up pressure, so you wanna release that pressure. You don't want stuff in there, and you pop this, booyah! Terrible. Alright. So you do your thing. Alright. Okay. Make sure that's shut. Wait, make sure. Okay, cool. Alright. So, you about to handle your business. Fill it up with some water. Well, first, you pour some water down in there. Pour some water down there. You know, a couple pumps. I'm going to show you that. Put some water in there. Then, you put these in. I'll leave a link for this. This porter pack. These like little blue droplets, drop it down, they deodorize and it breaks down your solids, toilet paper, if you're using RV toilet paper. Breaks down everything, you don't have no smell or nothing. Get them on Amazon, like $10, like 10 of them. I'm gonna leave a link for that in the description, okay? So you put some water in there because the water has to dissolve that. So you put some water in there, dissolve that, right? All right, so the way you put water in, like this. Pull up on this, it's a little pump. See that? All right. Get your water popping. Remember, you gotta fill this up first. Handle your business, right? You know what I mean? Handle what you need to be handled. Okay, and when you're done, you just pull this handle here. This is your little flush handle. You pull that. and everything go bye-bye. Shut the handle back like this, push it back. Boom. You good to go. Clean up anything, whatever, scrub brush, because you don't want any skis up in there, right? Boom. That's why I keep disposable gloves with this all together. Disposable gloves, toilet paper, porta pack, everything. Good to go. So you handle your business, you cleaned up, everything good, right? Now, you get back to the crib. Now it's time to dump this, right? Cool. Easy breezy. Got these latches here on the sides. Lift up. See that? Boom. Now it becomes two compartments. I gotta lift this. I can't do it one hand. Alright, hold on. I'll be right back. So you see, they take it off two hands. Easy breezy. So you go to your bathroom, to your toilet, whatever. Oops, hold on, y'all. And this pulls out like this. Hold up. Sorry, bro. Hold on, y'all. Pull that out. Unscrew that cap. Push, hold that button down. You dump it right on in there, and you're good to go. You can pull this out. You know what I mean? You might just eat corn or something. Rinse that all out. Good to go. You see what I mean? Good to go. Rinse it out, bleach. Bleach it down. Then put this back on there. Fold this back. It's like that. Then you put your top piece back on. Latch it down. You good to go. Now, this thing is great. Trust me when I tell you. Only cheeks on this thing is these cheeks. It's clean. Everything. Works good. Lasts long time. I'm telling you. Alright, people. This is a Serene porta potty. I'm going to leave a link description down below. I know you like you crazy, but I'm telling you, I shut these doors, lock them, handle my business, open up the doors, I got the screens popping, air it out, and then you always got to have, oops, that's not the air freshener. And then I keep air freshening with it. Get it all nice and smelling good. It's good to go. And I know you're laughing, but trust me when I tell you, people. All right? Serene porta potty. I mean, porta toilet. It's a portable toilet. All right? Link in the description. And as you can see, comes in this carry bag. Comes with a carry bag, so you can put in the carry bag after you know you're done with it, whatever. Boom. Now, with water in it, it's a little heavy, but you know, at least they give you a little bag to do your thing with it, whatever the case may be. But works good, lasts long time. All right. I just got finished editing some more video. Had to take a little break, rebuild this engine. Then I'm going to sleep. Alright, people, this is your man Rajay 111. Don't sleep. Peace.